How you like that? How you like some of that? You're trapped in quicksand. Ha ha ha. You cannot get away, and I can zap you with lightning. You suck. Hello, everybody. This is Nick the Creep, and we're back on the Riotcraft Feed the Beast Infinity server. Yeah, that's right. We're back. Alright, so let's turn around and look at a few things right quick. I haven't done a whole lot in the workshop here. I made this chain of machines here that produces clay for us because the deco bench is going to require a lot of clay. And there's a few other things I needed clay for. But I didn't want to have to go out and harvest it. And you see we almost have 8 stacks of clay. Here in a second I'll include a clip of me working on this and, well, not working on it so much as explaining the process here and what is happening. Getting the slag and the water, using an autonomous activator and a reservoir back there. But I'll show you that in a second. So I've decided to kind of switch gears for a minute and start working on something a little bit different. We are going to do some Thaumcraft. Ooh, Thaumcraft. So I already have my arcane workbench, and I've been doing a lot of research. I have pretty much everything unlocked in here in terms of, like, the aspects, I think. I've got a few supplies down here, brought the shards down here. But this is the room that we are going to do our Thaumcraft in. The ceiling needs to be cleaned up a little. But we are going to put our infusion altar down here. It's going to be so glorious where we can see it from up above. Oh, yeah. And then we're probably going to hollow out underneath here and make these walkways glass around here so we can walk around and see down there. And we'll have storage and different things and all of our aspect jars around and about and stuff like that. But this is just straight down the hallway, actually. I decided we'd kind of make that one of our center crown jewels. And I kind of did this thing here. I don't know how I feel about this. I'm actually considering a whole entire redesign in terms of block choices. Like, I think we're gonna maybe possibly try out the factory blocks and the laboratory blocks with this sort of design. And I don't know, we'll just see where we go from there. But I'm gonna include that clip real quick while I'm gathering up some viz in my wand and such. And then we're going to try and craft a few Thaumcraft toys, possibly. Hopefully something that's fun that we can play with. So stay tuned, and we'll be right back. Alright guys, check this out. Check out what I got going on here. I made a little production here. I did something like this in a previous world. It's not running the way that I want it to quite yet. But I needed clay in a previous world for a project. And the best way it seems to make clay is by using slag, water bottles, and in the old world you could use gravel, which was much more convenient. Here we don't really have an unlimited supply of dirt, and making dirt would require a whole nother process in itself. So if we have a quarry running, which we usually will, we'll have tons of dirt, so it won't really be an issue. Before, I was pulverizing cobble for sand and gravel, and the recipe used gravel with the slag and the water, so it worked out really well. The gravel we were getting, we would use in the recipe to make our clay, but we already have like 5 stacks of clay, which is amazing. So let me just kind of run you through how this works. So we need slag, and from what I can tell, the best and cheapest way to get slag is in the induction smelter with sand and cobble. You get slag one piece 100% of the time, I'm pretty sure is what it was. So we're pumping sand and cobble in here. We also have a pulverizer, pulverizing cobble and turning it into sand. Okay, first let me also explain here. We're getting slag in the secondary, but in our main slot, it's actually creating stone bricks. And what we're doing with those stone bricks is we're pumping them over here into a sag mill, and it sags them back down into cobblestone, which gets pumped into the pulverizer to create our sand and gravel. Gravel we don't really need, so it's just going up in there. But the sand either goes into the barrel, back into this induction smelter, or yeah, that's all it'll do. It'll go either into the induction smelter or into this barrel. Now, we also have a sag mill here for sagging sandstone. Now, if you sag mill sandstone, most of the time you get 4 right there. So you get what you put in it back out. And you also get niter. And niter is a really useful component for a lot of different things that we're going to need eventually. So we are using an auto crafter, which is slow. I know, an auto workbench. It's making sandstone out of sand. And it's pumping that sandstone either back up into the here or right back into the top. It gets sagged. It comes back down in, turns into sand, and it does it all over again. And this is just, sometimes this used to actually give you more than 4 pieces of sand, which I don't think is working now. We were losing sand, and still we aren't, we're not getting sand fast enough. I need to upgrade this pulverizer so that we can get a steady sand supply. Or what we really need is a lot of sand up front. Like what I've been doing for now is doing this, and we'll not pulverize it, but sag mill it, and continue the cycle. I have an autonomous activator down here. This is actually a really cool little trick with a reservoir. And I put 2 iron buckets in there, and that will fill the buckets up, empty buckets, out of this reservoir and put them back into its inventory. And we can move those water buckets straight up into here for our crafting recipe. And then when it gets enough sag, it will create clay, and it will push the empty bucket you saw out and back down into here, and it will go back and forth, so that's how we're getting our water supply in our auto-crafting recipe here, which is pretty awesome. Overall, this works pretty good. I wanted clay for the deco bench, and we're getting clay. I also wanted a bunch of sand. And last time I did this using dark steel, your bonus output is 200%. And the bonus output on this is extra sand. So I assumed here we were going to get quite a bit, like 4 to 6 maybe. But we're on average getting 2 to 4, which is really disappointing. So we are going to have to continue to pulverize cobble. And really, we need an upgrade. Alright, so we are back. And I went ahead and made one of these, alchemical whatever thingamajiggers that we can make stuff in with the stuff and the bubbles and the cauldron look and stuff. Yeah, so this is just an ordinary Minecraft cauldron you put down. You click it with your wand, and it transforms. We add a little bit of water and a heat source underneath, and we get bubbles. We get the bubbles, and then we can make a few different things with that. It's actually a nightmare, but I figured we'd put that over there and kind of make this our office, and then over there we'll try and do that stuff, the viz junk. So let's take a look at our Thaumonomicon. What should we get into? I want to go ahead and make a great wood rod, and I went and grabbed them. Oh yeah, we need to make our goggles too. Here we go, we got our goggles right off the bat, just like that. We got our great wood rod. And we're gonna need these to see the nodes a lot easier. It's gonna make things way, way easier. Now I wanted to make, we can make some gold caps for this new wand. Actually, let's see, if I have thaumium would be a better option. I really don't like that you can't group click things in this. It's really annoying. Let's go ahead and make 2 gold wand caps anyway, and then let's take a look at our book. So far all we have is copper, gold, and then missing the required research. So we might actually have to research this one to get to this one. I can't really remember how that works. Like, if we have to do, like, a specific phase first. I don't know. But we're going to go ahead and we're just going to do this. It's no big deal. We're going to make the Great Wood Wand with gold caps. This is going to hold more than this wand. This has 25. This has 50. So we're going to step it up a little bit in the Thaumcraft world. And for now, we'll just toss that in there. And then we want some of these, especially this one is what I want right now, the wand focus of equal trade. And for this, we're going to need 4 balanced shards, 4 quartz, and a piece of quicksilver. Quicksilver we can get from cinnabar. So we probably have some. I know we have Cinnabar. Let's go see if we have four quartz, and then we'll worry about the balanced shards. That's where things are going to get a little more fun. So it does not appear. Oh man, I need to clean this up right quick. We need to toss some stuff in here. We need to get rid of all these. Whoa, hey buddy. Junk blocks. That can go in there. That can go in there. That can go in there. Let's get rid of some of this stone. This. Get rid of all the stuff. All the stuffs. Get out of here. Dirt. Okay, we're looking a little bit better. We'll just throw that in there. A little bit better. Let's make these into torches. Oh, that's. Oh, what? Okay, let's get rid of that. That's even better. This is a charm of life from the Twilight. I've been carrying it around. I'm pretty sure if you die, it like you don't die. I don't know. It's hard to explain. I think you come back with all your items. I don't really remember how it works, but I'm pretty sure you have to have it in your inventory. You might even have to have it in your hot bar. But we'll worry about that when we're close to dying. So, Quicksilver, let's get a piece of Cinnabar. I think there was some in here. Cinnabar, Cinnabar. Okay, I think one will do it. And if we just smelt this. Yep, there was the Quicksilver. Quicksilver. And then, whoa, I'm running all over the place. Quartz, one, two, three, four. And let's clean this up a little bit real quick. All this aluminum. Make this into blocks. Blockity blocks. Okay, that's good enough. Put the rest back. Oh, why does it do that sometimes? I hate when it does that. So look, we have a ton of ores already. A lot of blocks. A lot of iron, gold, redstone. These are quartz blocks. I don't know why they're in there. And I found some dark diamond ore, dark emeralds, and some dark lapis as well somewhere. Which is, you can find it in the bottom of the ocean. In these weird, abysmal stone, like, I don't know how to explain it really. These big crazy places. So can we sag mill these? I didn't think so. Can we pulverize these? No. Okay, so we have silk touch on our pick, so we got to break them some other way. I wish we had fortune, some way of fortuning them. Is there something that I'm forgetting that we could do to try and fortune them? I don't think so. It doesn't even look like we do have a normal pick, so we can break them. Because I think we are missing, yeah, we're missing a couple of them. We need fire, we need earth. So let's see, earth. Oh, there's some right here, which is quite convenient. Let's just break them all up, I guess. Because we're gonna need all of these. Unfortunately, we don't have fortune right now, but that'll be all right. And I think we have to mix. Like, we have to throw one of these. Excuse me. We have to throw one shard of any color that we want into that bubbling cauldron over there. But first, we have to add so much of certain aspects. And I actually believe that the easiest way to do that is using a lot of these shards because they each have one of the base aspects. So here in a second we'll look at the book because I do not remember off the top of my head what it takes to make a balanced shard, but we will find out after we get all these goodies right here. Yeah, this is what sucks. I could take the Silk Touch book off of my Draconic pick real quick and we could bust them up with that. But oh no, I made my Tinker's tools where I didn't put anything useful on there yet. Did we put Silk Touch on that? Thought we put luck on something. I guess we put it on our sword is what we put luck on. But that's something I will have to remember to do. Okay, so we got a bunch of shards. Let's throw them all in here. This crappy appetite. Where's my book? Let's put this back away and throw that in there. And let's see what it takes to make one of these balanced shards. So we need two air, two earth, two fire, two water, and then two order or two perdido. So five of the six base aspects, more or less. We need two of each. So what I would do is 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, and then we'll grab these and we'll just bring them with us for making the actual balance shards. Actually, let's just bring all of them because actually we can use stone for earth, that's right. Let me see if I can find a few things. I know that stone. I don't feel like searching for everything that we need, so we're gonna do two of those. What? Why did that do that? That's not what we want. I didn't think these had extras. Why did it give us extra stuff? Okay, see, we got one balanced shard. Yeah, that's not good. We don't want that. So we need to try and find some other items that we have. Let's see. That have. Why doesn't it show us? Oh, I guess because we haven't scanned everything. That's not good. Okay, so sandstone is a good one. That has three of the earth and three. We'd like to work in even numbers if we can. Definitely be a lot easier. Darn it. Thaumcraft is such a pain, really. Okay, this is a good one, a furnace. Can we throw one of these down and scan it and see why did we get so much? Oh, they do have extra stuff on them now. That's not good. Oh, they all have diamond and that magic wand. Okay, that's not good. Well, we got one of the shards. This will give us fire, earth, and entropy. Man, what a pain. This is the one thing that I don't like about Thaumcraft, is trying to get started and trying to make things halfway efficiently without making a huge mess. With this Viz stuff, this stuff. Yeah. And look, why are we getting more stuff? Why is there fire in there now? Whatever. Throw that in there. Throw that in there. It's all right, we can handle this. It'll be fine. What are we missing? We need some of that. And then that should have given me two, 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 two. That should have given me another one. Why are you not giving me what I want, sir? Oh, this is bad. What are we missing now? Okay, whatever. We have four. We have four. There's a lot of stuff in there. Let's just do that. Whatever. It's fine, right? It'll be all right. Oh my gosh. Don't tell anyone about this. Don't let them see what happened. Okay, so we have these, the four quartz, and then the quicksilver in the middle. Oh, come on. We want this thing so bad. This is gonna be. Oh, where's my thing? Insufficient. Insufficient viz. What are we missing? It says that we need Terra. Is this wand? This wand is capable of doing it. We're just short. Oh my gosh. So that means I have to go and try and fill my wand up again. What are we missing? We're missing a lot of stuff again. We used it all up. Let's drop off some of this junk. It'll actually be easier now, because I have these goggles, which is a plus side to the whole endeavor. So sit tight and we'll be right back. I'm gonna get this stuff and then we're gonna make this awesome wand foci and have so much fun. All right, guys, I was flying around and we're right here by base. Like, this mountain here is where our base is situated. Not right here, but around the corner there. And really close by here is a bad dude. This is no ordinary node. I have to be really careful not to get too close. This is a hungry node. And you can see it's making this giant crater. It is absorbing anything that gets close to it, and it will actually grow and grow and grow. And if we get over there near it, it will suck us in and throw us, or possibly not throw us. We'll be lucky if it throws us, because we can get away. But it might not, and it might kill us and destroy all of our stuff. We could hold on to this and hope for the best, but no. So those can be captured, but we're not ready for that. All right, we're back in our room. We should have enough. Yes, we do have enough. We got a wand foci. Now, let's see if we can figure out. Oh, it is F. Oh my gosh, get ready for this, guys. This is gonna make my job with building so incredibly easy. Let's grab these, and we're gonna try out some different designs, I suppose. So we click here and there. Oh, and look at that. It's gonna make things so much easier if we wanna try different blocks, see how we like things. Is this out of. Are we out of blocks in our inventory? Is that the issue? I think we're out of viz in this wand. Let's grab the other wand and try it instead. So we're gonna have to get a better wand that holds more viz, apparently. But look at this. Yeah, so it will change all the blocks that you click on pretty much. And it looks like we're out again. But yeah, this, I'm gonna play around with some different designs using this. It'll make it much quicker. I've been mining all of them out on my own. I'm gonna have to definitely get a better wand. We need a silverwood wand with thaumium caps. Well, preferably, anyway. Let's look at this. We can make this pouch, which will be helpful. We can put our foci in. Three leather and a piece of gold. One, two, three. Three and a piece of gold. We can do that. Let's put that around there and like that. And what else did we need? One, two, three. Seven leather and gold. One and gold. Let's see. I don't know if we have. Oh, we do. Seven leather and a piece of gold. Oh man, this portal gun makes everything so amazing. This in the middle, gold on the top. We can do that. Mundane belt. And we have to have viz for that, huh? Okay, so we have a foci pouch now. So pretty much, let's see. Foci off. It will go into our pouch now. And we just carry this pouch and it will have all of our foci in it. Which will be wonderful. We're gonna make a golden bag just for all of our Thaumcraft stuff. I like to do that to keep things partially organized anyway. We need to figure out how to get to the next levels of wand, though. It's probably gonna take a lot of me reading through here and unlocking all this crappy research, which is really honestly the worst part about Thaumcraft. It truly, truly is. Smoky quartz. I really like this stuff. Really, really like it. Smoky quartz. And there's burnt quartz as well. Let's see. What can we do? Oh, we can also make this one. We need four quarts of potato and four air shards. Did I bring quartz with me over here? No. So let's grab one, two, three, four. Do we have a potato? Mr. Potato, we do have a potato. Wonderful. And one, two, three, four. And Mr. Potato, these in the corner. And some quartz. And a wand, insufficient viz. What about this one? Oh, that sucks. Oh, what's happening? Oh my god, what is that? Oh my god. Did you hear that? My heart started beating really fast. Yeah, that's side effects of Thaumcraft Ordo. That is like the one that I'm having the most trouble finding, actually. I think I know where there's like one or two nodes that have it, but I haven't really been. Yeah, see, I have like one way. That's 1,000 blocks away. There's one here in the desert somewhere. I think not this one. Did I take my. I did. I took my goggles off. See how much easier it is to see them? Hey, man. Okay, we're gonna have to knock these dudes out. Get out of here. Get out of here. All of you die. Die. Be gone. Okay, what's this one? It doesn't have the Ordo. Look at all these creepers. Creeper party. Creeper party, boys. Did I just get a creeper statue? Oh, I got a soul. This one doesn't have Ordo either. It has the air and fire. And I'm trying to remember to fill up both of my wands. Why aren't you? Oh, it's full on both of those. So yeah, it seems like we have to go pretty far to find. Ooh, is this a blitz or whatever? Yeah, it is. We didn't get a blitz rod though. That sucks. That sucks. Yeah, those are like the cold version of a blaze. So this is what I do. I go node hunting now. Super fun. Trying to find all the nodes so we can charge our wands so we can continue the Thaumcraftery. Or I guess, like, usually this is what I do. I mark them with waypoints. Makes it much easier to find them, but then the world can't load as fast as we can fly. Here we go. Here's one. Okay, we're full up there. Why are we full on like all the ones we can find? That I hate that. Ordo is like the one that's the worst. We use so much of it and we can't find it anywhere. Fire. Yeah, this is the one that we definitely want. Let's go over here. And there's barely any in it, like 20 something. Okay, that filled that wand up and then we'll drain it. And I did the research that keeps us from destroying nodes when we absorb from them. Man, today's not the day. Today's not the day. We're trying to do business here. Oh man, air and water, fire. We don't need fire for either one. What's this one got? Did we scan this? And then see, we get those which help us with our research. We get the like points saved to our thing, or I don't know what you call it, our research table. They kind of get saved over. But we probably have enough Ordo now in this one wand to do what we need to do, so let's teleport home. Get in here. And drop that. And the wand Foci. We got the Foci for shock. So, my inventory is full of crap. Let's open this and drop it in there. Foci, shock. And let's go find something to shock. Let's shock stuff. So there's some bad dudes around in the desert over here. There's always some bad dudes around. Come on, world. Do your loading thing already, please. How you like that? How you like some of that? You're trapped in quicksand. Ha ha ha. You cannot get away, and I can zap you with lightning. You suck. Oh, let's get this witch. How you like that, witch? You ain't got a wand like this. You don't got no magic. No magic. Yeah, so unfortunately, this is not very strong. But it is fun. It's cool. And it uses air. You can see up there at the top when I'm using it. It drains from my little air tank. We're almost out already. We're getting some creeper heads and stuff, though. That's pretty cool. Ow, cactus. So yeah, we got some awesome wand stuff starting to happen. I love Thaumcraft. And this is gonna make things, like I said, a lot easier for trying to design this base. I can convert a lot of this stuff over much, much quicker. It's gonna be a blast. I'm gonna love it. You're gonna love it. Let's try and get a few things out of our inventory real quick. And then I want to make a golden bag for our Thaumcraft stuff right quick before I end up forgetting. Oh my gosh. So much junk, throwing the arrows away. I'll throw this dirt away. We'll throw that appetite away. It was so much junk. And see, it gives us all these blocks back that we use the foci, the equal trade thing with. It gives us them all back into our inventory, which is nice. A golden bag, we need 4 pieces of wool. We need a gold block. I think we need 2 pieces of gold. Bag. A gold block, 2 pieces of gold. Yep. A diamond. 1, 2. A diamond. And then we need a chest. We can make a chest. And we'll make a new golden bag of holding. Is this how it was? Yep. And then we're going to put this in here and name it our Thaumcraft bag of holding. Thaumcraft bag of holding. And this is going to be for all our Thaumcraft goodies. Yay. This is our tools bag of holding. It's got all of our fancy tools and all the stuff that we need in it. I don't need that in there, though. I need to upgrade those tools some more, though, so that we don't have to worry about that next time with the shards. We can go ahead and fortune that stuff. Let's get this out of our inventory. Clean things up a little bit. Things are great. Things are good. We're loving life. But everybody, I think we're going to call it an end of the episode there for today. We started playing with some Thaumcraft. It's super awesome. We love it. I love it. You love it. If you enjoyed this, don't forget to leave a like. It really helps me out. If you're not subscribed, subscribe for the turtle. For the turtle on my head, subscribe. You know you want to. It's going to be awesome. I'll see you again next time. Have a great day, everybody. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.